Wednesday. My name is Kori Ashton at WebTegrity, and you have found a YouTube channel solely dedicated to all things WordPress. Just like our new sponsor here, Pressable, they only do WordPress website hosting, but why they're saying here that they do more than hosting is because they actually provide support as well. So if you have WordPress questions, you can chat with them, you can email them, you can give them a call, and they're right there to help you. Look no further for any great WordPress hosting. They're your solution. I'll put the link to them in the description box below. Please give them a shout out and check out their incredible pricing. Okay, but you're actually here to see the solution that I have for a scheduling resource or an appointment booking resource, right? How can you add a schedule option or a booking option inside of your WordPress website? I have a solution that I use in my everyday appointment booking process. It's a resource that I love. A couple of reasons. One, it's super flexible. It connects with my Google Calendar so I can change appointments on the fly from my phone. It's a fully responsive solution, so your user experience is amazing. And there's a free option. So if you watch my channel, you know that free is always in the budget. So you want to stay glued to this. I'm going to walk you through a little bit of the process of what it takes to get it all set up on your WordPress website. So before I go any further, let me actually show you what the end result looks like so you can get excited about this and be sure it's what you're looking for. We're using this on one of our current clients' websites. So you can book an appointment. They have two different cities that they're trying to gather appointments for in these cities. One is San Antonio, Texas. The other one is Houston, Texas. So we want to click on Book an Appointment San Antonio. Now, check that out. I didn't have to leave the website to go somewhere else to finish this appointment. All of this happens contained inside of my website, right? On this nice little modal or this pop-up that opens up. Very user-friendly, and again, it's perfect on the cell phone, so this is fully responsive. It shows them all the times that are only available, connected, kind of keeping a record inside of your Google Calendar. Oh, this is so cool. So any of these days are available. I can scroll through if I need to go a little bit in the future and book something on, you know, something down the road, August 6th. Now I get to go pick the actual time slot that's available on that day. Nothing would be showing here if it were already booked, right? It would be kind of muted here. So 10:15 is going to be my time. I'm going to click confirm, and now I get to fill out all of my details here. Excuse me. So anything that you want to kind of customize this appointment field, you can do that. I can click schedule an event, and immediately I get a notification to my email address, and then it also automatically sends to the company so that it's reserved on their calendar. Oh, it's so cool that that happens. And they also get an email in their inbox just confirming, hey, heads up, you've got an appointment that was just scheduled for you. It's a super cool solution. Again, totally mobile friendly. And there's a budget of free. So let's go look at the solution. It's called Calendly. And the pricing area here I'm going to show you, there is a free option. What you just saw on that appointment booker example that I showed you, we actually do have a pro version because we wanted to have the texting confirmation here. We wanted that feature inside there. So, but if you don't need that feature, all of the function that you just saw looks the exact same. Oh, it's so super cool. So let me go a little bit deeper and show you. Once you come to Calendly and you open up your account with them, what you're going to be able to do is have a dashboard that looks like this. Now, with the free account, you're only able to create one type of event. But I personally have the middle column account, and so I'm able to create multiple different types of events. So I have a meeting at the client's location, a meeting here at WebTegrity, a phone call, an hour phone call, a 15-minute phone call. I have some different options there for the different types of events or appointments that can be booked with individuals. And of course, it's super easy to create different types of events just by clicking Add New Event. And you're able to go in and edit so much the name of the event, the location where it takes place. You can customize the actual URL link that you'll be sharing with people, the color, when can people book this event. And you can come in, maybe this is only on Tuesdays from 3 to 5, whatever that looks like. You can even go in and create settings on the increments and how many of these appointments will you allow yourself to have per day. So maybe, you know, if you're booking 2-hour appointments, you're maxed out. You don't want to offer any other times. You can certainly set all of those incredible settings in each one of these areas per event. That's why I love this solution. It's just been phenomenal for me to use directly inside of WebTegrity. So how do we get it then to look super cool on your website? Once you've gone and created your Calendly account, right? You've gone over here, you've set up your account, whether it's free or premium or pro, you've set that up. Then you've gone and you've created your Google Calendar, right? All for free, all that's free. You've linked the two, which is super easy to do. Calendly shows you step by step by step how to do it. I did it within 5 minutes. I was off and running. Once that's done, how do you actually get it inside of your WordPress website? Let me show you those next steps because it's crazy easy. So once you have your different events, whichever one you want to go embed, we're just going to click on this little arrow down and look at this option right here that says embed. When you choose that, they give you three different types of function that you can have. An inline link that you can put on your website, the pop-up widget that you saw happen on my example, even a pop-up text if you wanted something like this. So I'm going to copy this code for a second, copied, and I'm going to jump over to a testing website really quickly. And remember, I'm inside of a page now, and I'm going to toggle over to the text section, and I'm going to paste in that little bit of code that Calendly gave me. That's all I'm doing. I don't have to write anything. It's a copy and paste function. And then I'm going to click preview and show you how simple this was. This is going to pull up just a preview page, right? You can change this text, of course, to schedule an appointment or whatever you'd like this text to say. I'm going to click that and look at it open up. It's going to easily pull up all of my available dates. You see, if it's muted, it's unavailable. That's either in the past or this is actually, I'm booked up those days already. I have no available appointments. So you'd have to schedule here. I only have limited appointments this day. See how it works? Pretty cool, huh? Oh my word. This is such a cool solution for you. If you wanted to change that area where it has the link, you'll see it here in the little bit of nerd code that says schedule time with me. You can say book an appointment. There you go. There's book an appointment. Preview it and you'll see that it's easily changed. Book an appointment now. You click there and it opens up and you're off and running. Oh, you guys, this is such a cool solution. If you have different options of how you're using examples of how you're using Calendly, will you put them in the description box below? I hope this meets your need for adding a booking or a schedule appointment on your WordPress website. It's such a cool resource and all in the budget of free. Have a great one. Be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel because every week I'm creating a video just like this for your improvement inside of your WordPress website. Have a great one, y'all. Bye.